there is no doubt that we are closer to the cure of cancer, but we are not yet there.
Cancer is actually a genetic disease. Now, when people think about genetics, they automatically think about what they inherited from their mum and their dad. What people don't realize is that throughout our lives, our cells continue to copy and divide, and new mutations are made. All 21,000 genes have to get copied every single time. That's a lot of genes. Mistakes are made. Most of the time, those mistakes aren't in an important place, and we're none the wiser. But occasionally, you'll get a mutation in a gene that's important in terms of how that cell grows and how that cell develops. If you get more mutations of that type in those cells have the potential to develop into cancer.
We're the melanoma capital of the world. In general, cure is something that we obtain very frequently by just simple excision. So simple surgery really cures a lot of these cancers. So really the question is for us, how to stop these cancers from happening in the first place.
We like to contribute now with our approach for the early detection, combining basically innovative imaging with AI, with genetics, and basically trying to work for a new ecosystem for the early diagnosis of melanoma and keratinocyte cancer.
And we're offering people genetic testing. Now, some of those people will have a really strong family history of melanoma, generation after generation after generation. But other people will just have a first cousin that had melanoma and they had melanoma. And we're trying to figure out the percentage of their risk that's attributable to genetics. So will they say, I'm at an increased risk of melanoma because my brother or my sister had melanoma, therefore I'm going to be good. I'm going to apply my sunscreen, put on my hat, put on my sunglasses, and get regular surveillance. Or there's another danger that they're going to say, actually, I'm genetically doomed anyway. What's the point in taking all of these precautionary measures?
Personalized medicine or precision medicine is a new model of healthcare. And I think it is around the combination of genetics, biology, lifestyle, and environment. And with precision medicine, we can address preventive strategies, we can work on the early diagnosis, and of course, of advanced treatment.
So if we look at the genetic profile of a cancer, we understand basically what makes that cancer tick. And if we know what makes it tick, we know where we can intervene to stop it from ticking.
I personally think that we still are just at the beginning of the precision medicine, let's say, endeavor. And in the next decades, there will be a massive, massive change, which brings us definitely a step closer to a cure of cancer and many other diseases too.